Remember me? Check this out. Little piece with Face to Face.
You know what? Regardless of like trends and musical fads or anything, we have a really strong East Coast following. So oddly enough, I think when our record came out, it was selling better on the East Coast right out of the gate. So, you know, we have a real strong East Coast following.
I don't think we've been a West Coast band since about 92, because 92, 93, we started touring, and we've been on the road nonstop with breaks off here and there, but and we've really kind of turned ourselves into more of a national act. We draw as many people in New York as we do in Los Angeles, so it's more of a West Coast phenomenon thing. It's more of a national thing.
Is this a band on the road where there's a lot of craziness that follows with you guys? You know, with every, especially being on the wrong
band you've ever interviewed, I would guess. Probably. So. You like to drink milk and eat cookies after the show.
Milk and cookies.
Watch Willy Wonka.
Yeah, I watched Willy Wonka last night and got really wired on candy.
That's a true story.
True. Where'd you get that Scorpions riff for your practice, and that, you know, sort of pulled that out at sign check today?
Yeah, well, you know, I'm a big Scorpions fan.
Did you wait till you got a major label to put your name on it? You know, like how you self-titled it.
No, that doesn't have anything to do with being on a made with what label we're on.
I just thought
it was
a conscientious thing.
It was we purposely did it, and we didn't wait for the third record, but we waited for an album that we all felt the most comfortable with as a band, and we all love every song on the record, and we all feel really strong about the album, whether it sells a million copies or 1,000 copies.
Don't matter.
Yeah, it's I think it's the epitome of the band, and it's what Face to Face is really about.